my pride and bust my face. Scatter my rights all over the place and take the bread from off my plate. But you can't break me. Lock me out, chain the gates, put black shirts in with dogs and mace. I'll hold the line, won't step away, 'cause you can't break me. I belong, you belong, we belong to the Union. Don't count me out when I'm on the floor. We'll win again, we've won before. The streets will ring with a mighty roar, 'cause you can't break me. Stocks rise up on workers' backs, profits soar while you hand out the sack. Boardroom bullies bloated and fat, but you can't break me. Australia's sold to mates offshore, backroom deals and shonky law. This day has come, we say no more. You can't break me. I belong, you belong, we belong to the Union. I belong, you belong, we belong to the Union. Turn away if you dare us to fight. I swear I'll never lay down and die. I'm in the Union, mate, got a right to belong. We'll be back, millions strong, women and men united as one. 'Cause you can't break me. There's a warning here to the men in grey. The piper's come, it's time to pay. We're taking back what you stole away, 'cause you can't break me. I belong, you belong, we belong to the Union. I belong, you belong, we belong.
Let us fight.
The deal was done behind a coward's door. They came in darkness, shadows on the shore. The snarl of dogs sent shivers through the night as Union men were thrown outside the wire. They locked the gates, hanging them in chains. They gloated, seeing working men in pain. We watched and saw a veil of darkness fall. Working men and women, we heard the call. And with these arms we held the line, and with these arms our strength combined, and with these arms made our demand, and with these arms we made a stand, and with these arms, arms that held a baby held alive. They'd break the Union with one deadly blow. If you're MUA, they said you'd have to go. 1,500 men cast aside. Their crime being Union had them fired. And hundreds grew to thousands through those nights. And faces glowed defiant for workers' rights. Police moved in, building workers moved behind. And mothers, sisters, brothers held the line. And with these arms we held the line. And with these arms our strength combined. And with these arms we turned them back. And with these arms took up the tracks. And with these arms, arms more used to papers held the line. When the likes of Reith and Corrigan make their plans and hide behind a screen of company scams, when they twist the law to shatter workers' lives, on the ground and bleeding, justice lies. But with these arms we'll hold the line. And with these arms our strength combined. And with these arms embrace the cause. And with these arms our spirit soar. And with these arms, arms that raised a building held the line. Attack my brother, you're attacking me. Deprive his family, you're depriving me. When my sister feels the lash of unjust law, I feel it too, and I'll take up her cause. And with these arms we'll hold the line. And with these arms our strength combined. And with these arms make our demand. And with these arms we'll make a stand. And with these arms we'll turn them back. And with these arms take up the tracks. and with these arms embrace the cause, and with these arms our spirits soar, and with these arms, arms hold on to arms and hold the line, with these arms, arms hold on to arms and hold the line.
Did you ever stop and wonder why the fellas on the job refer to Robert Menzies by the nickname Pig Iron Bob? It's a fascinating tale, though it happened long ago. It's part of our tradition every worker ought to know. Oh, we wouldn't load pig iron for the fascists of Japan. Despite intimidation, we refused to lift the ban. With democracy at stake, the struggle must be won. We had to beat the menace of the fascist rising sun. It was 1937 and aggressive Japanese attacked the Chinese people, tried to bring them to their knees. Poorly armed and ill-equipped, the peasants bravely fought, while Australian water siders rallied round to lend support. Oh, we wouldn't load pig iron for the fascists of Japan. Despite intimidation, we refused to lift the ban. With democracy at stake, the struggle must be won. We had to beat the menace of the fascist rising sun. Attorney General Menzies said the ships would have to sail. If the men refused to load them, we'll throw them into jail. But our unity was strong, we were solid to a man. We wouldn't load pig iron for the fascists of Japan. Oh, we wouldn't load pig iron for the fascists of Japan. Despite intimidation, we refused to lift the ban. With democracy at stake, the struggle must be won. We had to beat the menace of the fascist rising sun. For the Judas politicians, we would pay a heavy price. The jungles of New Guinea saw a costly sacrifice. There's a lesson to be learned, we've got to understand. Peace can only be secured when the people take a hand. Oh, we wouldn't load pig iron for the fascists of Japan. Despite intimidation, we refuse to lift the ban. With democracy at stake, the struggle must be won. We had to beat the menace of the fascist rising sun.
They speak about it proudly, it's now union folklore. Our wharfies wouldn't load any pig iron for war. Japan was a threat, so they walked off the job. They wouldn't help the fascists for old Pig Iron Bob. Well, they were right that time and they're right again now. But the strength of one isn't much of a power. So united they stand against all odds, fighting for us all against the little gods. Indonesia's young and fighting to be free, but the Dutch had different plans for their former colony. The people rose up with freedom on their lips, and the wharfies stopped loading many Dutch-bound ships. Well, they were right that time, and they're right again now. But the strength of one isn't much of a power. So united they stand against all odds, fighting for us all against the little tin gods. Korea was in trouble, overrun by the Yanks. Wharfies told to load rifles, guns and tanks. But why get involved in this bloody civil war? We're not gonna ship any weapons anymore. They were right that time, and they're right again now. But the strength given much of a power, so united they stand against all odds, fighting for us all against the little tin gods. Pig Iron Bob's back, says we're off to Vietnam, tugging his forelocks for good old Uncle Sam. The seamen wouldn't work, the warship Boonaroo, and the wolfies held the line when they sacked the ship's crew. Well, they were right that time, and they're right again now, but the strength of one isn't much of a power, so united they stand against all odds, fighting for us all against the little tin gods. The struggles moved on, mass sackings overnight. The Union survival is the heart of the fight. We'll defy your threats, your thugs and cod. We're standing united, no wolfie can be bored. You see, history's on our side, we'll see this battle through. There's too much at stake for the profits of the few. Our fathers before us stood on every picket line. Keep their memories alive, and we'll win every time. They've been right every time, and they're right again now. But the strength of one isn't much of a power, so united they stand against all odds, fighting for us all against the little tin gods. They've been right every time, and they're right again now. But the strength of one isn't much of a power, so united they stand against all odds, fighting for us all against the little tin gods. Fighting for us all against the little tin
the hungry, clothe the poor. In this world their number isn't few. In her cargo would you find any way for one mankind sailing on the Boonaroo? Oh, who will man the Boonaroo? Who will sailor be the crew sailing on the Boonaroo? Is there bandage by the reel? Is there medicine to heal? Christ knows there's healing work to do. In her cargo would you find any way for one mankind sailing on the Boonaroo? Oh, who will man the Boonaroo? Who will sailor be the crew sailing on the Boonaroo? Or would her hull be filled with material to build perhaps a bridge for a world that's split in two? In her cargo would you find any way for one mankind sailing on the Boonaroo? Oh, who will man the Boonaroo? Who will sailor be the crew sailing on the Boonaroo? Or jam-packed in the hold, is there grief and death untold? Asked why, I'd have to answer true. In her cargo would you find any way for one mankind sailing on the Boonaroo? Oh, who will man the Boonaroo? Who will sailor be the crew sailing on the Boonaroo?
I can't abide the government's front bench. Send them away to the Germans or the French. I can't abide Costello's shallow sneer. Won't someone make the bastard disappear? I can't abide that bloody awful Kemp. Bring back the gallows, the hangman and the hemp. Take Peter Reith and dump him in the tide. Him I particularly can't abide. Poor little John deserves our sympathy. Born neath the burden of mediocrity, pat his wee head and send him home to bed. Then hide the key lest he abide with me. Oh, I can't abide the government's ministry. Senator Vanstone's worse than dysentery. Send her away without the least delay. Don't pour the tea lest she abide with me. Oh, sink them, the swine, an iceberg would be fine. Far, far away in distant Hudson Bay, oh, as they go down, they warble while they drown. Flat and off key they'll go, despised by me. Oh, I can't abide the government's front bench. Send them away to the Germans or the French. Take Peter Reith and dump him in the tide. Him I particularly can't abide.
Well, hey ho, you land lovers, here's a tale of a ship of shame. A leaky tub that's manned by slaves, and the Bucket of Rust is her name. Bucket of Rust is her name. The flag of convenience she flies, the Jolly Roger of today, with laundered money, contraband, and drugs, and a crew that gets no pay. Bucket of Rust is a grimy old heap, it's a wonder she can float. And if she sinks, you can't escape, you can't launch the safety boat. Launch a safety boat. Hey, your rhinos are full of slime and scum, but what's even worse than that is a rancid food in the galley must be shared with the roach and rat. Gotta share it with the roach and the rat. Bucket of Rust is a great success, she's welcome in our ports. She undercuts our local ships with her cheapness and her rods. Cheapness and her rods. Deregulated industry is her blood, her lifeline. You can be substandard and be a sweatshop, and the government don't mind. No, the government don't mind. To say the Bucket of Rust could this have been God's will? On the Great Barrier Reef she ran aground with two crew members killed, two crew members killed. And it took them 12 days to blast her away and free her from the reef. And all through the time the oil she spilled, it brought the sea to grief. You know, it brought the sea to grief. It's hard to believe, but this story ends well for this great heap of shit. Minister for Transport saved the day when he issued a new permit. John Anderson is his name. It's a true story. Our shipping must be competitive, he said, in the world economy. So the bucket of rust continues to crawl like a coffin on the sea. A coffin on the sea. Yeah, the bucket of rust continues to crawl upon the grimy sea.
Maintained the pieces, we stood for our rights. They brought in the dogs and armed thugs for the fight. They went to the courts and the courts ruled our way. Why are we still standing outside today? Justice delayed is justice denied. Four judges have ruled that the right's on our side. Now give us our jobs back and fling the gates wide. For justice delayed is justice denied. It's pathetic to hear businessmen crying poor. They can't pay a fair wage, yet they pay for law. The law goes against them as rightly it ought, and still they have money to try the next court. Justice delayed is justice denied. For judges have ruled that the right's on our side. Now give us our jobs back and fling the gates wide. For justice delayed is justice denied. They say they can't pay us, the company's broke, and we'd all be laughing, except it's no joke. They're still paying scabs on the big hired bus, but they've stripped all the assets, there's no cash for us. Justice delayed is justice denied. For judges have ruled that the right's on our side. Now give us our jobs back and fling the gates wide. For justice delayed is justice denied. We're sick of injunctions, we're sick of the wait. While scabs wreck equipment, we watch through the gate. Our trust in the law's wearing weary and thin. It's time to do justice and let us back in. Justice delayed is justice denied. For judges have ruled that the right's on our side. Now give us our jobs back and fling the gates wide. For justice delayed is justice denied. Justice delayed is justice denied. For judges have ruled that the right's on our side. Now give us our jobs back and fling the gates wide. For justice delayed is justice denied.
Hey there, Johnny, the song it is for you. It's not behind the razor wire, hidden from our view. And that's why I'm wearing a black armband, a black armband, to demonstrate my stand. white picket financial security, leafy suburban nuclear family. The benefits of a growing economy, middle class utopia where the market is so free. But I got a better term for all this inequity. It's not incentivation, Menzies, nor prosperity. Not back to the future to 1953. It's myopia, which means that you can barely see. Balaclava guards, Rottweilers and Alsatians, such is the face of your industrial relations. Anti-union tyranny right across the nation, on the waterfront and down the mines, you're proud of your creation. You got the call to call it reforms in the workplace, when waging war on workers is a retrograde disgrace. You want us cap in hand to crawl, you're smug and mean and base. You want our rights and hardened gains to sink without a trace. Peter, this song's aiming at you too. You're mean of spirit, you and all your crew. And that's why I'm wearing a black armband, a black armband, to demonstrate my stand. 120 years of public education is being destroyed by your discrimination in favor of the rich or some denomination. You call that a fair go? It's an abomination. There's now freedom of choice in our school, and so you say. Who do you think you're fooling when most of us can't pay? Then if funding the elite without taxes is okay, then this nation will fall like a dingo-stricken prey. And hey there, Johnny, this song it is for you. I see rack and ruin and all the things you do. You can tell, cause I'm wearing a black armband for all those stolen generations you can't understand. Well, here's your report card, you don't get many marks on greenhouse emissions and logging national parks. And reconciliation, you've chained up all our hearts. You score a zero, just an odd, you get a buggery of arts. Of liberty, equality, fraternity, I didn't know. Ownership of shares is democracy, the way to go. But on a privatized planet, I guess it must be soul, where any soul is bought and sold. Your marks are very low. I know what you stand for, shrivel up and die. We'll throw it overboard, and that won't be a lie. But until that day, I'll wear a black armband in mourning for what you are doing right across the land. But until that day, I'll wear a black armband in mourning for what you are doing right across this, right across this, right across this, right across this land.
Purpose-built tugs that lag light boats attended, but bulk coal carriers in open sea. To fulfill that function, the union contended required 4 deckhands. Fenwick said 3. 3 deckhands and motor man just couldn't handle 16-inch polyprop double dead eyes. When the tow hook was black, the company gambled on a tension winch 10-inch comp C compromise. Brooks, Amelia, and Depot Serena, the sea snaps your hoses like thin strands of twine. Brooks, Samuel, Yando, Nebo, Serena, 100-ton bollard pole, 30-to-9. At 2 in the morning, we made fast to Martha. By 9, the Academy star had been birthed. Then old tugs and line boats returned to the harbor, their work being finished, the 4 crews dispersed. 5 the same evening, storm warnings were sounded. Cyclone approaching, no time for delay. At their burst, the big bogeys were taking a pound, and broad sounding bell, Yando must get them away. Brooks, Amber, Yando, Nebo, Serena, the sea snaps your horses like thin strands of twine. Brooks, Amber, Yando, Nebo, Serena, 100-ton bollard pole, 30-to-9. 2 hay point at full speed, the 2 tugs went dashing, got lines on the mother red wharf number 2. Though 12-foot green water on our decks was crashing, the order for maximum tow had come through. With a whole hull vibrating, the tension went slipping. Then came the moment that old tugman dread. The sudden lurch forward, the broken line whipping, the thought of old shipmates, the injured dead. Brooks, Samuel, Yando, Nebo, Serena, the sea snaps your hoses like thin strands of twine. Brooks, Samuel, Yando, Nebo, Serena, 100-ton bollard pole, 30-to-9. Well, the mother had cleared just as our line had broken. The Academy star was at wharf number 1. Though the help we could offer might be but a token, in her plight that help would be better than none. Time and again we tried to position so the tow might commence with all possible speed. With a jury-rigged line and in such bad condition, 3 deckhands and motor man could not succeed. Brooks, Amber, Yando, Nebo, Serena, the sea snaps your horses like thin strands of twine. Brooks, Amber, Yando, Nebo, Serena, 100-ton bollard pole, 30-to-9. Well, not fully laden and high in the water, the Academy star could not be controlled. With a strong onshore wind by her bow on the quarter, she slammed at the pylons till her hull had hold. And yet Utah's bosses and those who do their will send tugs to sea light on gear on demand. $1 million will be the repair bill. They pay that in preference to 1 more deckhand. Brooks, Amber, Yando, Nebo, Serena, the sea snaps, your horses like thin strands of twine. Broad sound bellyando, Nego Serena, 100-ton ballad pull, 30-ton line.
dockyards of my soul. Some names are written charcoal, some names are drawn in stain, some names are written pencil when the pencil has some lead.
There's vampire bats and sewer rats, there's pubic lice and crabs, but the lowest form of life on earth is a slimy Patrick scab. There's vampire bats and sewer rats, there's pubic lice and crabs, but the lowest form of life on earth is a slimy Patrick scab. And now before the sun comes up he crawls out of his pit, but you wouldn't get too close to him for the smell of slime and other little bits. Beneath the cloak of darkness he sets off all clad in black. To serve his wretched masters goes the slimy Patrick Scab. And when his treachery is done on his knees he crawls back home. His kids don't want to know him, so he eats his tea alone. They haven't been to school for days, they're ashamed that he's their dad. Tell me, what's your father do? He's a slimy Patrick Scab. There's vampire bats and sewer rats, there's pubic lice and crabs, but the lowest form of life on earth is the slimy Patrick Scab. He's not dead step inside a pub or an RSL for days, 'cause when you're a slimy Patrick Scab, the world don't seem too safe. He sits at home and counts his hoard to find out what he's worth. But what value would you put upon the lowest slime on earth? Alas, accidents do happen in the wharves and on the shore. A crash, a smash, a flash, a splash, and our scab's a scab no more. Nobody mourns his passing, no one's even slightly sad. Upon his grave these words inscribed: here lies a Patrick Scab. There's vampire bats and sewer rats, there's pubic lice and crabs, but the lowest form of life on earth is a slimy Patrick Scab. So he walks up to the pearly gates where the heavenly bell does ring. Says he, "I've worked hard all me life, you'll surely let me in. I've always done Mr. Corrigan's will, to have served him makes me proud. So please give me me halo now and me fluffy little cloud." Saint Peter slowly shakes his head and looks him in the face. "What makes you think that I've got room for scabs inside this place? You've robbed your neighbour of his job and his children of their food. You've stabbed your brothers in the back and betrayed your sisters too. My angels would lay down their harps, do you think that I'm that mad? And to burn in hell forever, dispatch that slimy Patrick Scab. There's vampire bats and sewer rats, there's pubic lice and crabs, but the lowest form of life on earth is a slimy Patrick Scab. There's vampire bats and sewer rats, there's pubic lice and crabs, but the lowest form of life on earth is a slimy Patrick Scab."
In a faraway country called Whoopland, a very rich merchant did dwell. He owned factories galore and ships by the score, but something was wrong, you could tell. For it seems that those terrible wharfies, when loading his vessels with flour, had complained of the task, even ventured to ask for an increase of sixpence an hour. Now the ship owner, being fair-minded, they always believe in fair play. To the wharf he did trudge, with his colleague, a judge, to toil with the men for a day. But the very first bag that they handled left the pair of them flat as a tack. In a state of collapse, each agreed that perhaps we should grant them that miserable zack. What a wonderful country is Whoopland! What a pity it's so far away! Though some people insist it doesn't exist, I'm going to find it one day.
Oh, cock of the morning, with a dream in his hand, my love has come home to the wonderful land. And he bursts through the door with his eyes like the sun, and his kit bag crammed full of the treasures he's won. There's a pearl shell from Broome and a Tordowan tail and coral and clam and the jaws of a whale. And my kitchen is full of the smell of the sea and the leaping green fishes my love brings to me. So tumble your treasures from Darwin and Broome, and fill with your glory this straight little room. With the sun blaze on his chest, my love has come home from the north of Northwest. And deep in our bed we'll love and we'll lie, we'll kiss and King Solomon's
song. From Norway Pier of we go, two pits heavy in our hand, for the big ship that's come in from a trip to foreign lands. Salty streaks of rust don't matter, but the mornings hold her tight, and we work to fix her engines all today and half the night. Don't wait up for me this evening, I'll be out all night again, working on the Brisbane River with the ship repairer men. Fired boilers throb with power, drinking up the furnace heat. Water turns to driving steam to make the engines beat. But the feed pumps of an oil to us cuts through all other sounds. and sing the song of triumph for the vows that we have grown. Don't wait up for me this evening, I'll be out all night again, working on the Brisbane River with the ship repaired of men. Engine bearings and knock and hammer in the wild and stormy seas will be machined and fitted till they run with silent ease, and the windshaft rattles every time the piston turns the shaft. We'll hum along and sing its song to men skilled in their craft. Don't wait up for me this evening, I'll be out all night again, working on the Brisbane River with the ship repairmen. When you see the ocean line and the light between the riverbanks, and the captain in his gold braid orders men of lesser ranks, have you ever thought this stately craft might never sail again? If it weren't for the toil and sweat of ship repair of men. Don't wait up for me this evening, I'll be out all night again, working on the Brisbane River with the ship repair of men.
Pay cuts, hell no, and scope, CMPs and name that.